simple pendulum. It's called a simple pendulum if the weight of the string is small compared to the weight of the pendulum bob, so that the weight of the string can be ignored. So we call the length of the string L and the mass of the pendulum bob M. We draw a diagram to show the position of the pendulum partway through its swing. So there's the arc it's swung through, and we'll call that length X. The length of the string is L, and the mass of the bob is M, and the angle from the equilibrium position is theta. Theta, the angle, has to be measured in radians, where the relationship between radians and degrees is 360 degrees, is the same angle as 2 pi radians. Using radians, I can say that the arc length x is equal to L theta, which I can rearrange to get theta equals x divided by L. The forces acting on the pendulum bob are T, the tension in the string, and mg, the weight. I can resolve the weight into a component F, which is tangential to the arc and is the restoring force that's trying to push the pendulum bob back towards the equilibrium position. So the component of mg, F, equals minus, because of its direction, mg sine theta. Now, another property of angles measured in radians is that for small values of the angle, the sine of the angle is actually equal to the value of the angle. Again, we need to remember that this is only true if theta is measured in radians. So I can rewrite my equation for the restoring force to get F equals minus mg theta. Now I've already worked out an expression for theta. Theta is x over L. So if I substitute for theta, I get F equals minus mg x divided by L. Using Newton's second law, I can say ma equals minus m times g upon L times x. Dividing both sides by m gives me a equals minus g upon L times x, which I can recognize is in the form of a equals minus omega squared x, since g is a constant and L is a constant. Comparing the two equations, I can get omega equals the square root of g upon L. Now, using what I know about the period of simple harmonic oscillations, t is equal to 2 pi over omega. So for a simple pendulum, t is equal to 2 pi times the square root of L over g.